Hi, welcome to this week's special episode of The Shtick. We're at the Wellness Wonderland in Warrandyte. That's www. Have you got a website?
I've got seven of them.
I'd like to introduce our viewers to Marc Cohen, Dr. Marc Cohen, in fact. And he's a very old, dear friend of mine, and the first time I've had a chance to leave my home in Caulfield North to get out of the zone. And here we are in Warrandyte. Hi, Marc.
Hey, Henry.
Good to see you.
Yeah,
we've been wanting to do this for a long time, and the time is now to give Marc a full shtick, because he deserves, he's got a huge mega shtick about wellness, and what we're looking at is complementary medicine and all the aspects of it. And Marc Cohen, tell us all about your shtick.
Well, what can I say? I want to be healthy and happy and have a wonderful life. And I've set out with a strategy to do that. And that has led me for a long career into medicine, because I figured to be healthy and happy, I had to learn how the body works. So I studied Western medicine, and then I took some time off and did physiology and psychology and understood the mind and body. Then I studied Chinese medicine. I studied electrical computer systems engineering, because I needed to work out how technology works with the body. And I've had a 30-year career in integrative medicine, which has been a very interesting career, really on the border between conventional and complementary medicine. Mm. And in that time, I've spent about half my career as a full professor at RMIT University, where I've championed the discipline, academic discipline of wellness. And that's got me involved in a whole lot of stuff that doesn't have a lot of money behind it, but it's got a lot of history behind it. So I've done more than 100 scientific papers on things like meditation, yoga, organic food, nutrition, herbal medicine, saunas, hot springs, health retreats, detox programs, all the stuff that doesn't have a big industry behind it, but it's the stuff that for me has been fantastic, because I've learnt all about these great lifestyle practices that can treat illness, but they're really designed to make you happy, healthy and well. And that's really been my focus. And just over two years ago, I retired from my full-time tenured professorship at RMIT to, do an outreach and go out into the world and become entrepreneurial. So now I've got a whole range of businesses that are all focused on wellness as well. So I've got a water filter company. I've got a company that does living probiotic kombucha wellness tonics. I've got a company that does they're adult books that are accessible to children with really profound messages in them. And then I've got an online academy where we're teaching people about water, and we're teaching people about how to be healthy. I'm still doing online medical practice. And then I've got a whole other company we're launching that looks at healthy homes. It looks at home health hazards and how you can assess them and how to turn your home into a health retreat. And I believe everyone's home should be a haven, and not only avoid all the hazards in the home, but really to have your place of where you live as a health haven. So, how to turn your home into a health retreat is actually multifaceted, but it's what I'm really passionate about. So I've been doing that here in my home in Wellness Wonderland. So I've got, saunas and spas and cold plunge and lots of hammocks and, edible landscape and orchards and growing a whole range of plants and herbs and fruits and vegetables and having a lot of people coming in my home and sharing that. So it's great to have you out here again. I know you've helped me. You've been here on building projects and weekends. Certainly, yeah. Where my friends come over and they help me build stuff, and we call it building, bonding and bathing. So people come over, we build stuff, we bond, because when you're working together with people, you really get a good relationship, and then we jump in the sauna and the hot tub and the pool and cook up a meal and connect. So yeah, That's my life.
Fantastic. There is so many things that you've covered here that we don't even need to do three segments now. I think we've covered it all. But I'd like to firstly get into your academic thing. You've been involved as a consultant in so many books and publications, which I think is amazing. That's your academic side. And then you've also got this thing which is the water filter. I'd really like to start with the water filters.
Yeah, so I mean, it wasn't my intention to go into the water filter business, but I've always been really passionate about permaculture and the principle that when you get the basic things right, everything else can go right by itself. But if you get the basic thing, if you get the basic things wrong, it's really hard to play catch up. And one of the most basic things in life is water. And you know, we're about 2/3 water by volume or by mass, but if you count the molecules in your body, you're 99.9% water molecules. And that's because water is really tiny compared to collagen or nucleic acids or proteins. And you know, I've been talking about water toxicity and you know, how our microbiome, the bacteria in our gut and on our skin, are so important for our health, and that it's not good to be waging war on those bacteria with chlorine and pesticides and antibiotics and you know, disinfectants. And I've been telling people, you know, to get a water filter.
Just tell me a little bit about this.
So these water filters, they didn't actually exist, so I had to actually create them. So I've got the best components, Russia, America, China, and then this is the under-sink filter or the whole apartment filter. So this will do a whole family.
So tell us about the logo. I think
the logo took a long, long time. So the Beautiful Water is the brand, and these aren't just filters. So Beautiful Water is filtered, it's structured, it's balanced in terms of pH and minerals, it's blessed, and it's free. And that means you don't pay for the water, but it's free-flowing. You're not storing it in a tank. And the logo itself is like a water droplet, it's like a water crystal, it's got flow forms, it's got bubbles, and it's got sacred geometry of Metatron's cube. And Metatron's cube has all the platonic solids, and the lines of Metatron's cube actually are text. And if you have a magnifying glass, you can read that.
Tell us what it says.
It says, I love you, I respect you, I thank you, I bless you, I am you. Over and over and over and over again in each microscopic line.
You have to see it. We'll be flashing it on the screen.
There's no other water company I know that does filters that are beautiful, but if you talk to Indigenous elders, Indigenous wisdom says you want to hold your water sources sacred. You want to feel good about where your water comes from.
Yep.
And rather than coming from some industrial, meter. So, you know, having a water source that's beautiful, that's blessing, that's got intention in it, changes your...
What about the other bits there that you've got there? They're the inserts.
So, this is actually the insert of a vortex device. So that's the vortex device.
Yep.
This is not a filter. What this does, it's structured water, and it forces water to go into vortexes. So this is, if you have a look inside, these are silver, copper, and zinc plates.
Right.
It's like a little propeller there.
And did you invent this?
I did not invent this. This was invented. It's patented in Switzerland. So a company called Swiss Aqua patented this. And they sell it to a lot of factories because it stops scale buildup in pipes and in water boiler units and kettles and things. It also, once water is structured, if you grow plants, you get 30% more plant growth with less water use. If you're making bread, you get moister dough and moister bread. If you're making concrete, you get stronger concrete. If you're washing windows with this, you don't get streaks on your windows. If you wash your hair and your skin with this, you don't get soap scum and scale building up on your hair and your skin. So this is not just an industrial product, it's a beauty product, it's a health product, it's a cleaning product, and there's no moving parts. It's just the physics of this turning water into vortexes. It pretty much mimics a mountain stream.
Wonderful. We're going to end the segment here, and we're going to come back and talk about your tonics.
Yeah, well, they're actually made with beautiful water.
Exactly. We'll be back after the break with more of Dr. Marc Cohen talking about his shtick.